hello. My name is John Thornton. And I have become known as the king of the Barack Obama press pool. And many of you have called or emailed or written or just thought to yourselves, how did he get that reputation? How did that man, that John Thornton, become so universally respected as a video journalist? How did I do it? It wasn't easy. But I have made a little film for you to see some of my techniques in action. Watch and learn as I cover the Democratic presidential primary in Pennsylvania. I always try to get a feel for the streets. So what's it looking like tomorrow?
Everyone's going to be very excited. People on the street.
Okay, good luck. Every campaign has its peddlers and camp followers. Get to know them, and you'll get to know the campaign. Have you sold anything?
Oh yeah, plenty.
What are people buying?
Shirts mainly, any size. Got them for $10. Can't beat it.
That is a pretty good deal. Any Hillary stuff?
No.
Why not?
No money on that.
All right, can you say that again?
No money in Hillary, period, dot.
To Ken Borough to hand out flyers in Rittenhouse Square, my son and I, in support of Barack Obama. We're very excited.
Realize that, amazingly, not everyone is for Barack. But with a little bit of luck, these heretics will be prohibited from voting. Where are you guys from?
St. Thomas, Virgin Islands.
And you're just visiting Philadelphia?
Yep.
Hi, how are you doing?
She likes the camera.
Are you guys allowed to vote? Do they have...
Not for president.
Really? Why is that?
Because it's a territory. It's not a state.
Ah, so are you? Who would you have voted for?
What, here?
Yeah.
I think Hillary.
Hillary?
Sorry.
Don't abhor delusional voters. Here in America, the right to waste your vote on a loser is sacred. Any predictions? Who's going to win today?
John Daugherty.
How about for the Democratic primary? For
one
president?
Of them, bitch.
But you just only care about Daugherty, huh?
John Daugherty's my guy.
Throw in the beautiful sounds and sights of the city. Another technique I use is as old as Shakespeare itself, a little bit of flattery. It usually gets a blah, 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 tongue wagging. Blah, blah.
Excuse me, the fact that you have a coat and tie makes you look kind of like a more of a big shot. Are you like a professional political person?
I have been a candidate in the past, but I'm not a professional politician, no.
But you're a supporter.
Oh, absolutely.
And why do you think he would be better than, say, Hillary?
Well, I think that...
Sorry.
On the issues, I think Senator Obama has more of a sense that things need to change. We can't just throw slogans and band-aids.
Don't be shy about barging in or interrupting other reporters. How's it going so far? Are there any turnout results?
We have not heard out.
According to the New York Times, they think that if the turnout's real good by one, that would favor Obama. Don't hesitate to make the story about yourself. This is called gonzo journalism, and it's a highly respected technique.
Well, we don't know. I'm going to go down to a polling place and ask.
Okay, thank you.
Good luck. A little case of camera envy on my part. I'm in the center of a beautiful Philadelphia City Hall looking desperately for somebody to tell me where there's a polling place. You'd think City Hall would be crawling with political types who would know where the polling places are, but it just looks like your average citizens. Yes, we can, but unfortunately, I still can't find a polling place. Question, do you know if there's a polling place nearby?
Here's the number, because I'm from Jersey.
Oh, I'm from Jersey, too.
Oh, what part?
Ocean City.
Oh, Hackensack.
Ah, so then present.
Let's see it.
Any poll result?
I haven't been tuned in.
Well, I finally found it. This Lucky Strike building, apparently it's a polling place. Doesn't look like it's real good turnout, unfortunately. Let's see if we can find anything. Well, this is a little disconcerting. I was told by two people who are very desperate that this was an election polling place, and yet it doesn't appear to be. So I wonder if voters are going to be able to know where to go. It appears to be more of a bar, and definitely don't seem to see any voters here, so we'll have to keep looking. As a journalist, I am a highly ethical creature. So when I see a civilian about to make a mistake, I will definitely show him the error of his ways. Are you guys going to vote?
Yeah, I'm registered Democrat.
In Pennsylvania?
Yes.
Where's the polling place around here?
I don't even know. How I did it was I just signed up last minute. They're handing out like papers,
right,
information. I still haven't received my card yet, so I'm kind of waiting for that, and then I'm going to vote.
Well, today's the day. You got to vote today. Today's
Don't have my card. That's a problem.
Yeah, that doesn't matter. Tell them that go and do it, and they'll let you do it, and it'll be
a
provisional.
Where is the
place of- I don't know. That's what I'm trying to find out. But who are you going to vote for? I don't want to give anything away. Okay.
I was thinking about Obama.
All right. Well, go vote now. Go vote. Hey, you too.
When F. Scott Fitzgerald famously said that the rich are not like you or me, he must have been talking about me.
I came over to Market Street, where a lot of the big Philadelphia banks and financial institutions are located, and tried to talk to people with suits on, and no luck. Everybody seems snooty over here in the moneyed area, including the bicycle messenger types. They wouldn't talk to me either.
And how did I deal with this particular situation? Well, I'm a teacher part-time, in addition to being a journalist. So I found one of my most attractive female students, and I got her to stand next to me to lure a businessman over, and then I could talk to him. It's known in espionage and journalistic circles as the honey trap, and it works every time.
Unbelievably, I have gotten a person with a tie to actually talk to me. So you're a Republican, you said?
Yes, I'm a Republican.
And do you think McCain would be much better than Bush, or?
Yes, he's not my first choice of all the Republican candidates, but he's better than Bush.
I really want to thank you for luring that man with the tie into talking
to me.
You're
welcome. I think you could have done it without me, though.
Well, this is John Thornton, king of the Barack Obama press pool, signing off. I hope you learned something today, not only about Barack Obama, but about the profession, journalism, which I so dearly love. To village ghetto land. See the people lock their doors while robbers laugh and steal. Beggars watch and eat their meals from garbage.